It was claimed during the referendum that those who benefit most from EU membership are the metropolitan elite in London. London is genuinely the most globalized part of the UK, and as such, the less dependent on European markets for its prosperity. In contrast, many parts of the UK, especially in the Midlands and in the north of England, are heavily dependent on European markets for their trade and prosperity. But in fact, these are the regions that voted for Brexit. The economic readjustments following Brexit are expected to be more challenging and difficult for the UK's weaker regions. In part, this is because they are more dependent on the European market, but also because they are less resilient. Most of them, because of their economic structures, will have no representation on the Brexit negotiations, where major sectors, such as automobiles and financial markets, are likely to have a significant presence. At the moment, the only parts of the UK which are represented in policy debates are the four nations. But our research is going to look at all the UK's sectors, regions and cities where the impacts of Brexit are more varied and severe. Our research is likely to throw up major challenges for the devolution in the UK, as precisely the time where devolution is being encouraged, these areas are going to face even greater challenges.